Welcome back to Fox College Football, sponsored by Ram Trucks, built to serve. You see all the fireworks in the sky here in Ames, and guess what? There were more during the week for Iowa State, Texas, Allison Williams.
That's right, Jason. Plenty of fireworks, plenty of emotion, because there's plenty on the line for both of these teams as they're trying to play their way into the Big 12 title game.
Since the college football in November, these fans are wired, the players are wired. Let's go.
Through the haze of the fireworks, the kickoff into the end zone, and Texas will have it first. Quinn Ewers back from the AC joint injury in his shoulder.
Two catch.
Because, in part, they're without Jonathan Brooks, who tore his ACL last week, and this one goes flailing out wide and incomplete. So Quinn Ewers behind a starting offensive line that has been together the entire season. A couple games of the season for Texas before Brooks took over, and C.J. Baxter is belted and dropped. Tyler Onyedum with the hit. He is a great pass rusher there in run support. Joey Peterson, the defensive end, a junior from the state of Iowa. This game means a great deal to him. He's an Iowa State legacy player. Gary Vaughn's in his 61st college football game. It is his senior night, and Bo Freeler, who got high praise, very high praise, the Brock Purdy of the defense, said his coaches. Quinn Ewers to throw. That's over the middle. It's a catch for Adonai Mitchell, and the touchdown maker has another big catch for the Texas Longhorns. He finished the game last week.
Huge version.
Iowa State is the best third and long defense in the Big 12 this year. Ewers over the middle. The great tight end, Jatavion Sanders, his first grab. Will this be the first running play for C.J. Baxter? Couple of tight ends in there. It's Ewers again, flowing to the right and throwing to his right. That's low and incomplete.
State's got to win in the margins. That's penalties. That's kickoff return yards. All the little things.
It's a second down throw after the incompletion, and it's juggled and put on the ground by Worthy. It's incomplete. They'll blow it dead. That's an incomplete pass instead of a runaway for Cooper.
Field, a little curl route. But these corners are physical. This whole defense is physical. They're the number one total defense in the Big 12. Not a surprise with Matt Campbell and John Haycock.
Down early in this game. Ewers to Baxter. It's lit up and in the air, and that ends up on the ground. So C.J. Baxter on top of it. That was Bo Freeler with the massive dislodge.
In this scheme, the safety that's usually free in the run game, and in this case, he's got to contain the speedy true freshman, and he doesn't stop. There's certain guys, Jason, that stop and wrap. A lot of these Cyclones, and Freeler in particular, run right through contact.
They swept the leg while he was at it. That was Freeler on the hoof on C.J. Baxter. And Rocco Becht, who has gotten more and more comfortable and more accurate as the season has worn on.
Yeah, we saw him early, right? Did a nice job in the opener, very conservative plan, and then we saw him against Iowa. Well, it turns out Iowa's a heck of a defense. But the following week against Ohio, he was sick, and at halftime, he was throwing up. And it was then and there that Nate Shieldhouse and Coach Campbell said that's when he won this team over. No excuse, went back, went to work, continued to fight, and each and every week since, Jason, has just gotten better and better and better.
The only one half he really wants back is the first half against Kansas. Their only loss in this string, and that is incomplete. It's off the hands of the freshman tight end, Ben Bramer, out of the state of Nebraska. In motion right there on a second and 10. It's a handoff, and it gets about five. That's a run for Eli Sanders. We'll see three running backs likely for Iowa State in there right now. He's creeping up to about the 20-yard line against a very good third-down defense, and that deflection ends up forcing an incompletion. That was Tavondre Sweat. He's so fun to watch, fun to talk to. Tyler Perkins to punt it away, and he's going to be big tonight. That is a boomer by Perkins all the way back to the 32. It's a 52-yard punt, and field position so big for this Iowa State team trying to pull off an upset against Texas once again.
The group of players for Matt and John that have just given them life through all the adversity. It's Coach Haycock that broke down with us yesterday emotionally, saying they have given me life back in my coaching. Special, special group.
It's a first down run for the Texas Longhorns, and C.J. Baxter pinballing for a first down. keep them together, to talk to them, to inspire, to discuss. And boy, is this a together group. Pressure from Onyedem, and Ewers goes down. Joey Peterson got home. It's a loss of nine.
Touch. And Quinn Ewers has plenty of time, but he's going to look back at eight different defenders looking at him in zone. And this is what I'm going to be curious of, Jason. When we saw Quinn Ewers earlier this year, he ran. Night.
And can they win if he doesn't? Second down, 19. It's Baxter hopping through with some burst. Not a big blitzing team, Iowa State. They do come, and they do get there. Onyedem was in there once again with Gary Vaughn.
It punctured and collapsed around Quinn Ewers. Onyedem has been active. Vaughn, as you said, playing his 61st game. The biggest hug, the last senior to be announced with Matt Campbell.
Iowa game, they lost 10-7. And Matt Campbell said he even felt like he was playing a little bit not to lose. This team puts the ball on the ground right there. It's on the deck. Their turnover margin's been so good this year, and they do get on top of it. Jalen Knoll out of bank by not turning it over this year. Their plus nine turnover margin, and they dodged one that time. All right, so how does Iowa State do this with Matt Campbell tonight?
He's done it three times, knocking off top 10 teams in this building, possessed the football. One time of possession in all of those, nearly 35 minutes. Situationally special, third down, red zone. He's got to win those. Be penalty positive. I talked about earlier winning the margins. And then an old Pete Carroll 101, number of rushing attempts plus pass completions. You win those four areas, as he's done in those other top 10 takedowns, you win tonight.
Here's a run on first down. It's Eli Sanders. Second down, Rocco Beck sees pressure, throws it. Dimitri Stanley, and he's got a first down for Iowa State, gain of 12.
Bob.
Guy breaks it down and throws incomplete.
Smart. That's a good throwaway. Spot. Goes five and underneath just to get into rhythm.
It's a run on second and 10, and Eli Sanders is dumped after a gain of two. Date, Vernon Broughton has checked in on the defensive line for Tavondre Sweat, and Rocco Beck loads up a deep shot down the sideline, incomplete, but a marker in, Higgins.
Pass interference, number six, defense.
Keep an eye on that, on the perimeter, how they're going to call those pass interference plays.
Texas fans might be saying that was uncatchable, but there was a lot of contact, and so it's a run for Abu Sama III, who had 3 seconds on its first touch, now has a sustained drive here. Becht, that's a slant, and it's Higgins on the catch for a first down.
One, just a little slant route to your right. You're going to see Beck do a nice job of putting on the frame of his big receiver. Be first down run. First down run and be conservative. A lot of first down pass here early for a reason.
Yeah, he does not want to be in third and long against Texas. This is a draw, and it's Cartavius Norton creating some space. Weighs bigger than everybody I played against for my entire life. Decked another slant, other side. It's Higgins once more, and he's been huge on this drive, first down.
Used his frame on the go route, now back-to-back slants. And you kind of start to feel the confidence of Rocco. He is a rhythm quarterback. And he knows how to use Higgins on the outside.
Eighth play of the drive for Iowa State. It's back down the middle, a little bit behind his target, and Jalen Knoll didn't really have a chance.
Pass behind.
Rolling and throwing near side. Oh, what hands on the sideline. That is an amazing grab by Daniel Jackson.
There's a lot of Knoll, and then every time you look up, two or three of these a game. Just a veteran player, a fourth-year player, tiptoes perfectly.
Yeah, heads up, stop by replay. The receiver went out on his own. He did reestablish. You see a great look here. Left foot's out of bounds. He reestablishes with another body part, but he's the first to touch. He can't be the first to touch. That's an illegal touch, and basically it's a loss of down at the previous spot.
After further review, the runner went out of bounds on his own, came back in, and was the first to touch the pass. That's a foul for illegal touching of a pass. Results in a loss of down at the previous spot. It will be third down at the 21-yard line.
Field goals could be important in this game. Changing the play here. Back giving ground, stepping up, and he does take a sack. 18 for 22 this year, the transfer from Nebraska. It is on the way, and it is good. Was sort of the harbinger for what this series would become as Texas leaves for the SEC after this year. Keelan Robinson wants to return it instead of take it at the 25, and that's a minus six. Fourth first down pass tonight for Texas, and that does get to the wide side, and the first catch for Xavier Worthy.
Filo to get it there.
These receivers are so good after the catch as well. That's Baxter. What are you seeing mechanically so far from Ewers?
He wants to play. He's sick of sitting on the sidelines.
Texas has college football playoff hopes. There's a flag that has come in right in the middle of the offensive line for Texas.
Holding, number 52, offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay second down.
You can see right here. I mean, just you can't get outside the frame. They bank on you not being able to, and they bank on it well.
Jaden Blue is in the tailback with the catch there. Iowa State has allowed four touchdown drives all year. Ewers on third down. Got to get to the 46, and this is nearly intercepted. My, oh my, Malik Verdon nearly had his third pick of the year and the 16th for the Cyclones.
Receiver releases inside. He's got eyes to the quarterback. Vision to the quarterback. That's what elite zone defenses do, and that's what John Haycock's crew has developed. It might just be our 16th interception of the season.
Ryan Sanborn with the kick. And this will go rolling and rolling and rolling and nearly magnetized itself to Jalen Knoll. Didn't he leave a couple years ago? There's all that opportunity and whatnot. He said, look, we stayed because this is what we want to do here. Build something, as that goes for really no gain. So many opportunities for other guys on that line, including Sorrell and Burke. That's a defensive back blitzing, and it's Jaron Thompson getting the hand up. Pressure coming. Hansen picked it up for a moment, and then Beck goes down. Quite a bit recently, and seen teams come back at them. This is a different looking game so far, as Worthy is back for another blast of a punt from Tyler Perkins, but it's returnable. And Xavier Worthy shot out of a cannon across the 35-yard line. Very returnable deep punt for Texas. Play action. Baxter is the outlet, and he's to the fringe. Baxter playing because Jonathan Brooks was injured last week with a torn ACL.
Inspiration for these guys.
A sizzling catch and run guy as well. This is a run for Blue, and he's going to set up third down and two for Texas. Blue again, and he tunnels forward right into contact, and that should be a first down, although let's see. Yeah, they are going to bring the sticks forward. Ewers scanning, running. Ewers wants to throw on the go. Flag comes in. It's into the end zone, and it's Adonai Mitchell for a touchdown if it stands. It's on Kelvin Banks Jr., who had zero penalties all of last year.
I'm right here tangled up, and this is all about Dominic Orange. If Dominic Orange gives up on this play, and he's a 330-pound nose tackle, there's going to be no hold, but he doesn't. And that's an excellent call.
20, another self-inflicted issue for Texas. It's a throwback on the screen. It's Blue. Blue has a convoy, and he's sideswiped by Bo Freeler. Injuries they've suffered over and over again on the offensive side recently. Wow, a little soft shoe by Blue, and he is thwarted, drilled by Freeler and Vaughn. Both defenses live here. Pressure coming. Ewers back foot into the end zone. Incomplete. Adonai Mitchell, the target, 40 this year. This is true. We are tied.
This is gritty.
Beautiful Ryman Gardens outside of Jack Trice Stadium, where Texas tries to keep its college football playoff hopes alive with just one loss to Oklahoma in the waning seconds at the State Fair. The Longhorns have just tied the game with a field goal on the board for the first time tonight.
Shout out to Scott and Chase Ryman. I know watching this one and watching again, as you said earlier, just an epic kind of Cyclone night. Gritty, tough, and more than likely close.
Haycock, guys who really helped build the program, including the strength and conditioning coach as well. They made a change there as Rocco Beck, the freshman, hits Jalen Knoll, and he's at the sideline at the 42 for a first down.
To take advantage of those outcutting routes.
Rocco Beck running behind the freshman tight end, Burkle. Second down and 8. Beck just kind of flares it out there for Bramer in space, and Ben Bramer, that looked like a shot put without any power behind it, a gain of 15.
One block away from Bramer hitting his head on the goalpost. Look at the true freshman. He's looking to his right. He doesn't have his eyes up. If he just puts a body on Catalan Bramer, the long strider, the gazelle, he's in for a touchdown. Just a little learning lesson from a true freshman that is growing with everything flying around him.
Those freshmen who have really established themselves together there. This is Sama, another freshman. And Rocco Beck, short set. There's another slant. It's on target once more, and it's Higgins on his third slant catch of the day. To back twice on those third downs so far. Beck. Another short set, and that is caught by Knoll. It's very close. He's going to be, it looks like, right near the 30-yard line, and they will say it's a first down.
Feel for that space. Ooh, he gets collision there by Barron. Where is the ball?
He's going to be bobbling the football. Watch the bobble as he's driven back. As soon as he regains control, that's your point of forward progress.
That's great, Dean. Continuous control. It got interrupted. And so it's Contreras from 51. His career long is 56 earlier this year. From the middle of the field off a high snap, and that one veers on him. It's no good. To our Longhorn enthusiasts feel like maybe the offense can break out. Quinn Ewers the throw. He's got it to Xavier Worthy against TJ Tampa. Gain of 11. Downstairs Allison.
Injury 10. It looked like it was maybe a lower back or hip issue.
They had the foot injury earlier this year. Baxter did. And this is Baxter, and he is dropped by Will McLaughlin. Ewers throws it far side, wide open Worthy. I mean, wide open. He is inside the 30, stood up by Cooper. They got 29.
A little more benefit of the doubt.
It's a flip, and it's Worthy coming this way. Xavier Worthy behind Sanders. Ball on the deck. It's still loose. A Texas player had a shot at it, but couldn't come up with it initially. And now let's see. Christian Jones was down there, and he flew over the football. Freeler says it's cyclone football. It is. Cooper with the helmet on the ball.
Jeremiah Cooper. Jeremiah Cooper. All you do is take the ball away. Shinclaw. Cooper can't do it better. Haycock loves it. That's what this team has done this year, Jason. Plus 10 in the turnover margin.
In high school football, he has been all over the football his entire career, and he did it again. This is a throw for Beck. It's tipped and incomplete. David Benda nearly had a runaround pick six for himself. Two outstanding efforts so far, Heward. Here's a throw. It is Steve-O Klotz, and he is a yard short. He's out of Chaska, Minnesota. Beck, little jump throw this way, and it's Jalen Knoll, who Rocco Beck said, look, I have such confidence in as a human being. Yes, on the field, but man, do they have a relationship.
Well, I like it.
So do you run him laterally here? Let's see. It's Beck to throw. It's down the middle, and it's a low grab this time by Jalen Knoll. Man, his hands are soft, and a marker comes in as well on the hit.
Personal foul. Targeting number 2 defense
with the crown, and you can see it's actually the receiver who's going to drop his head. I don't really see the defender attacking here. I see this as more of a collision.
After further review, there was no foul for targeting on the play.
Thank you so much. First down for Iowa State. Nonetheless, they won't tack on the penalty. This is a run right into the car wash.
Great sounds there.
Brock Heward, Foley artist. Second down and 10 for Iowa State. low scoring first half. So much on the line. Rocco Bet, another slant and another bullseye to Higgins.
Slant play. 49ers made a living of it. I think a guy named Rice in Montana were pretty good, and you keep taking it, and then you know ultimately, Jason, in your back pocket comes the slug off. At some point.
James, third down and three. Becht to his right hand, and he whistles it incomplete. Tyler Perkins to Xavier Worthy. Strong return earlier of 22 yards. Worthy again, right down the middle. There is a marker in. He is out of here, and Xavier Worthy scores.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 21 on the return team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Night because of what happened earlier, but they can get real close. It's a first down run after the penalty.
There and run by that gunner anyway, and Ewers would have got the ball off.
Instead, it's C.J. Baxter getting fed, and he gets wrapped up by Miles Purchase. It's exactly how Oklahoma did it earlier at BYU with a defensive play. And this is another sack of Quinn Ewers, and once again, it is the Iowa native Joey Peterson.
Great tackle, just one-on-one, and it's effort. And I'm telling you, earlier in the year, Ewers feels that. Maybe he steps back, he improvises. When he sees a three-man rush, he's got to help his guys out just a little bit more.
Football. Instead, he decided to come to Iowa State, where his father and brother went, as Quinn Ewers flicks this out at Jatavion Sanders, and that's one of those arm angles from Ewers.
There, in just a little flick, just those that spiral that he creates.
They'll ride it for a little while. Now Ewers to throw right down the middle. That's a completion and a first down and then some. It is Whittington breaking tackles to the fringe and a big hit for the Longhorns. Tampa ushered him out. It's a gain of 30. To play right guard, one of those 17 offensive linemen, and there is a whistle and a marker on the far side at the 31.
False start on the offense. The unit never got set before the snap. 5-yard penalty, first down.
In the backfield, Quinn Ewers steps up and checks it down. It is Blue out of the backfield, and he is out of bounds at the 29 with Verdun. Give him about six. Has been a live wire so far tonight. Second down, nine. They go empty again. Ewers with a cross. He's got Whittington, and he is torpedoed. Miles Purchase.
He is, as you just said, a torpedo. Miles Purchase out of Cherry Creek, a multiple state champion in Colorado. I watched him in high school, Jason, and to see how he's transformed his body into a 205-pound.
Third down, six for Quinn Ewers. Pressure coming from everywhere. Ewers steps through, floats it, and incomplete down the middle.
Was he in the pocket under pressure?
Number three, offense. It's a loss of down at the spot of the foul. It will be fourth down.
And to
the
be clear,
a 10-second runoff.
Yep, if there's somebody kind of close, there wasn't here.
No, you're going to see the deep post go all the way here, and the throw goes between the goalposts. So to Dean's point, that deep post was crossing the field, and Matt Campbell, he loves it.
So this ends up being a 50-yard try. First half, Bert Auburn's long is 49, and we have a timeout, and that would have been no good.
Texas takes their second timeout.
This would be his long. And now Iowa State will call a timeout. Now, you can't call an individual team cannot call back-to-back timeouts, but if one team calls a timeout, the other one is available to call a timeout, and Matt Campbell takes the opportunity to extra freeze. He missed the one prior to the timeout. This one is on the way, and it is good! A career kick for Bert Auburn. Game, and never has music and a sponsor and a game fit better. Ram Trucks, Screamo, and 6-3.
50-0 right now in penalty yards.
Four sacks as well for Iowa State have hurt the Texas Longhorns. And we go to Allison. Tons of stuff in that report. Thank you very much. Rocco Beck to throw to the far side, and somebody slipped over there. The coverage slipped, and Higgins makes the catch for the first down.
There for Iowa State, and too many third and longs.
It's a first down run. They ran 10 times for 5 yards.
Guys just keep slugging away.
Good block, too.
It's another run. It's 2 straight runs, and Eli Sanders gets a composite 4 on those couple of carries. That's up top. Noel in the slot on 3rd down and 5. That's Noel in motion. Beck looks the other direction and throws it there for a first down to the tight end, Ben Bramer.
Yeah, he's going to come right here, and then there's catch radiuses. And when you're 6'7", there is nothing more appealing to a quarterback than seeing space.
In that whole gambling scandal, they lost 5 starters in that. This run is going absolutely nowhere. It's a bunch up top for Rocco Beck. Quick hitter that way for Sama. Blackwell missed the tackle, and he turned into a battering ram. 2 for 7 on 3rd down for the Cyclones. Beck hops out of the pocket, rolls and throws, and he's got the running back Hansen. But now you're going to be 4th down at about 6.
Nice.
It was not a shallow cross. Here is Perkins to boot it away for Worthy, who's been great back there. 1st down for the Longhorns. 15 first down plays, 11 passes, just their 5th run. That was Worthy in motion. They'll go Baxter, and Baxter hops through, turns, and has a 1st down to the 33-yard line. Leaning into Iowa State here with some muscle. It's Ewers to throw, and that's a low throw that buzzes off the ground to Worthy. 2nd down, Ewers. Pressure right in his face. He steps up and throws, and he's got it for Worthy, who breaks outside again. Texas top 15 in the country in yards after the catch. And Ewers fakes it to Blue, whips it out for Blue. Catch and run, and he is dragged down at the 41-yard line by the walk-on Caleb Bacon.
4-star, and they show off their athleticism.
C.J. Baxter, the 5-star. I mean, that lap from Sanders, that's Whittington in motion. And they'll run the delay again. Baxter was slowed up that time nicely in the backfield. And a 9. Ewers will throw. Far side, just the 2nd catch for Adonai Mitchell. Got to snap it. Ewers to throw over the top. Right there, Whittington. Touchdown.
And then he goes right by him. The advantage of fifth-year players and not true freshmen is they know when their number's called. The biggest to date yet.
You know, before the season, he got asked, why did you come back to school this year? His answer was, gotta get that Big 12 championship. Nice sell.
Just running into the pile. Tremendous call and even better execution.
Line drive, Noel. Jalen Noel just kind of covers up. Team has been through a lot with the injury to Quinn Ewers, the loss early in the year to Oklahoma that was rather unexpected to the fan base. As this is a run, they're going to try to establish a run, but Sama is just crumpled. Right? 2nd down and 9. Texas so good at forcing 3 and outs. This to the wide side, and Bramer is just spine-bustered. Can you run it? Can you? Would you think about it?
Can you play pass it?
A short set. They're going to hit Noel on a 1st down. First down. We see the tempo and Cartavius Norton play action. It's Beck slinging it down the far side. Oh, what a throw! Jaden Higgins with a beautiful.
We thought we would see a slant and go. We didn't need to see a slant and go. Just get the big body on top of Ryan Watts right there. And when you win early and it's even, that throw takes you leaving.
Ball.
Perfect.
And that is right into a black hole. It's Baron Sorrell with the hit. I mean, just into nothingness.
Yeah,
there were trips at the bottom. Beck, it's a middle screen. It's Bramer. Ben Bramer right up the zipper inside the 15.
You know, they see him come from the outside in. Earlier, it was 1 block away, and this time the cavalry gets out in front, and I am telling you, the dude is a gazelle at 6'7".
Strong red zone defense. Iowa State has scored every trip into the red zone in Big 12 play so far. Back. Throw direction on the lob into the bucket. Touchdown! Eli Sanders with a parachute into his lap.
You're going to see the play action and Sanders have the same hesitation, right? We watch Whittington do it. On the other side, I'm going to be patient when my number's called. I can't sell it early. Tremendous call from Shieldhouse. And what an answer.
Oh, and it's a blocked extra point. Here comes Texas the other way. Austin Jordan in control of this thing through the night in Iowa for two. And everything else up to take care of that puppy.
Ends up and make one heck of an impactful play.
I mean, that was like Kevin Durant, right? Like that was rejected. Ah, the return, Keelan Robinson. Twist. I mean, come on. They were unstoppable in Tempe today. Somebody's gonna have to cement it against very good competition. Quinn Ewers fades to his left and throws on the run and got it to Worthy. The ball sprang free and it's incomplete.
Because it was a beautiful flick of the wrist, but just behind and giving Verdon's big body an opportunity to rip that out and not survive the ground.
Third and nine. Ewers lobs it middle of the field, knocked away one-handed. Jontez Williams got the arm in front of Adonai Mitchell.
That is teaching tape. I think Haycock is waving and saying, put that one on the reel too, please.
The seniors on this team, that was the theme in the preseason as this boot is going to go bouncing into an Iowa State player, and TJ Tampa had to fall on top of it. Iowa State and the freshman quarterback, Rocco Beck. He wants to throw on first down. Loads of time this time, and that is undercut and intercepted. Jaron Thompson flies in for pick number three of his year.
To throw it now. Throw it now. We saw this a couple weeks ago with an interception with Dylan Gabriel. It was just a hitch route, and you could not take a second hitch when you're throwing that deep over to his Longhorns.
First down run, C.J. Baxter so explosive, and he sizzles through that hole into Verdon. It's a first down, gain of 13. First down throw, pitch and catch for Adonai Mitchell, and he's down at the 30-yard line. And
Coach Campbell, and to start the fourth quarter here, a one-possession game, what is the biggest thing you're telling your defense right now?
Well, we got to just continue to do a great job trying to put ourselves in advantageous situations. You know, if we get them second and short, they've been really productive. We got to do a great job, put them in second and long, and then we got to do a great job getting off the field.
Thanks, Matt.
Thanks so much.
Can they do it here? Ewers down the sideline, Gunner Helm. Texas touchdown. The blocked extra point that went back to the house. And it's coming this way for two. It's Whittington. A lot of action in front of the eyes that time as well. And Texas makes it 23-9.
That is the quality of a veteran play caller making adjustments.
So now Iowa State, how much can you run the football? They'll do it right here with Sama, who was winning a state title just last year in Des Moines at Southeast Polk High School. And there is Malik Verdon heading into the locker room. Nolan motion. It's Becht on the keep, and he'll lean forward. Third down and two, it is Sama. And he is met and driven back. Going for it here. Fourth down and one, it's Becht. Pop pass over the top. East End.
Are you kidding me? How do you leave this guy?
Because you committed to stopping that run. Run on first, run on second, run on third. Give that defense something to think about, and then when they sell out, you crush them.
There's always the next offensive mind in college football.
They like to say the eye in the sky never lies. The eyes on these defenders are lying an awful lot tonight. Game kind of emblematic. chronic of Iowa State season of just continuing to dig and dig and dig.
Just find a way. Stick around. This return for Keelan Robinson back to the touchdown.
Top.
And it did. And here we go. Texas next possession. Gwen Ewers, Gunner Helm once more, and he tiptoes out of bounds. Give him about 8.
Oklahoma, the only one stung this year.
C.J. Baxter, he approaches the line and hits the line
yes,
hard,
does.
Doesn't he? No, they've punted Baxter at points tonight. First down for Texas. Ewers. Deep ball down the sideline. It's short, and Mitchell got hit by Purchase as he tried to adjust.
Back on a one-handed catch. An obvious pass interference early. Purchase is beat on the deep out and up.
Second penalty only against Iowa State, and it's Baxter, and he's got 5.5 at Texas.
Yeah, the 2 tight ends as well.
And we have a false start coming, it looks like. Timeout first. Timeout. Texas. And tonight with a some-way tie for second place or first place in the Big 12. We just don't know how much carnage there will be. It depends on this ball game. Texas can be a game up on everybody for one of the 2 spots as Quinn Ewers readies to catapult, and now he throws it on a check down, and he's got C.J. Baxter for a couple of yards. Baxter and Blue both in there. They'll hand it off for Baxter, and it's a first down, Texas, with about 10 to go. Makes it a 7-point game. Instead here, it makes it a 2-score game. So field goal range matters for Sark. Baxter got by McLaughlin and then gets smushed. Baxter up top. Quinn Ewers with time. 2 throw casually to Baxter, and he leans for what looks like a first down. It's a couple of weeks. And so now Baxter closer to full strength as they will run it with Blue, and he goes down on. Ewers flips it out wide. Baxter is dumped. Submarine by Purchase.
Watch the cornerback process the game in front of him, see exactly what's coming, and deliver the tackle for loss.
And now you're right in field goal range, but questionable field goal range. Pressure from the corner. They're going to pitch it for Blue. And Blue gets enough yardage to set up the 3. That looked like an intentional idea to make sure that you could make it a 2-score game.
Absolutely smart.
Auburn drives through it. It's on the way, and it is good. He striped another one.
This Saturday, just staying alive Saturday.
That is exactly what it is.
Packed today.
We really do need better stats for defensive linemen and what they disrupt. As this comes to the near side, Higgins breaking a tackle. And he's across the 40-yard line and driving ahead to the 43.
Urge this season, 33 receptions coming in, and just a career day. A little bit of physicality there. The two-handed push gets away with it. And Muhammad, the freshman, gets burned on the missed tackle.
Sama. Taken down after a yard.
That's the best thing about those big guys and the impact they have on the entire team.
Out to Hanson on the swing pass, and he is thrilled. Touchdowns in high school in a year. Anthony Hill Jr. with the stand-up tackle, 3rd down and 3. Time ticking away on Iowa State. And their chances to make the Big 12 title game. Beck flowing and throwing, and he does have a first down.
His vision. Yep, guess who? The defensive line, there's Sorrell, there's Crew Murphy.
4 players in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty, replay 3rd down.
Well, we saw this pop up last week.
2 are both off the ball. He is on the ball, he is on the ball. He's got to be off the ball, and that guy's got to get on the ball. That is just a mistake you can't have.
For a moment, now he flashes back into the backfield. It's 3rd down and 8 against one of the best 3rd down defenses in the country, and there you see why. Team, they have to get to the plus 47. And Texas will hurry up the clock of Rocco Beck, who throws near side, and it's Hanson trying to break a tackle. He won't do it. Campbell down the stretch, got him the victory. Can they make it back to the college football playoff? Quinn Ewers hurt, but leading this team up by 10.
Can't afford to lose in the biggest moments down the stretch.
Toss for Baxter. who has been outstanding tonight.
Impressed.
Personal foul, hands to the face, number 58, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, it's on Singleton.
Can I speak for Longhorn fans and tell you that I think they probably won a national championship?
Well, I'll say this.
False start, number 54, offense, 5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
Some people would say it's the single best win in college football this year.
Yes.
That Texas has. CJ Baxter just roaming, grazing all the way to the 20-yard line.
Yeah. That and the sweat medallion. We are the jewelry game of the week. We had a lot in reserve there. Right into the pile. And let's see if they go for it. We'll get a timeout. You know, we saw the deep ball against Alabama and how good that was in that game. It's straight up the middle, and it's going to get the first down, and that will ice it.
That is Texas tough. And tonight, they answered that call.
Yeah, and I don't
games. And in year number three, he's got a team of a ton of depth, a ton of fortitude, and is displayed tonight, a ton of force.
First time since 09, a 10-win regular season for the Texas Longhorns.